Thank you for this opportunity to come and talk at this prestigious institution. In fact, a couple of days back, when Bio from our office had come and told us that, you know, we're getting this opportunity to talk, my first question was, what is the topic? So the topic was tourism technology integration challenges. And so fair enough, you know, we've been through our fair share of challenges, we've understood them, so not a problem. My second question was, how much time do we have?
15 minutes.
Yes, so that's what she said. So I thought that was more of a challenge. However, I think we've been able to address all these challenges in this short and brief presentation. The theme of our presentation stems from the fact that technology integration and adoption are, you know, very integrated and related. So if the demand for adoption of technology increases, integration problems should, you know, subside faster. Also wanted to point out, as I address the challenges here, I see that the demographics internationally and specifically focusing on India for this presentation are rapidly changing. And with the coming of mobile, we'll see most of these challenges developing into newer challenges. So before we understand the challenges for any industry, the idea is to understand the industry in itself. So the Indian tourism technology industry, I would like to say, lives in many digital centuries, has many various mindsets. So are these deterrents? Not really, but we have to understand them and address them effectively and accordingly. So as I mentioned, that we as a country, in terms of technology, also live in various centuries. So here is a photograph which I have to pull out of a high-rise building with a tennis court, swimming pool. Next to maybe a slum. So I heard this analogy a couple of weeks back in one of the presentations, saying that God forbid if there was a Holocaust to, you know, come over this city or wherever in India, archaeologists would come and they would try to find out what kind of people lived here. So they would find a sickle, and then maybe they would find a blackberry. They would try to, you know, sort of figure out how were they coexisting, or were they, you know, what kind of people were actually living here. So this is basically trying to show that the kind of how technology today is being adapted. At the same time, we have different levels of adaptation in different demographics here to prove the same. I've taken an example of a typical, say, Indian family, anywhere from 2 to 3 generations living in one house, looking for an Indian, trying to book an Indian holiday. They would like to adopt technology. The junior most people in the house, say the teenage children, would like to adopt technology faster and say, we like this, you know, let's just book online, let's pay by the credit card. The senior people in the house might be adverse to using the credit card, want to meet those people personally. So this is just an example of showing how technology integration will happen faster in the tourism space as you know, the newer generation is coming on, growing up, becoming decision makers, making more money. So there was a study, a classification, as stated, I read somewhere, where they said that people born before after 1985 are digital residents, and those before 1985 are digital migrants. So there are a lot of people amongst all of us here, including myself, we're still digital migrants. We're still trying to, you know, sort of come to terms with what is happening. As, you know, Jack directly said that, you know, there are a lot of things out up there, and we're still trying to understand and, you know, come to terms with them. The new generation would say, pay online, as I mentioned, and that's how the world does it right. As a result, technology integration has shown that you know, we're not being able to penetrate deeper, especially in India, in terms of sharing travel. All the technology and the OTAs and so many platforms are available. Still, mostly domestic tickets are sold online. Hotels and hotel packages are, you know, still struggling. And I see this fast changing with the change in demographic. Connectivity, to a certain extent, is still deterrent, but with the coming of mobile phones again. A mobile phone is the first introduction to internet for a lot of people, whereas for a lot of people, including in this room, including myself, my first introduction to the internet was through the PC and then the laptop. But now people coming onto the internet are coming directly through their mobiles. So the cell phones will fast change the integration of media and travel setting. Today, coming back to the same example, today people in villages also have their mobiles, and I'm sure rail and air booking will start happening from mobile even faster as we go ahead. The impatience level. will also help the impatience level growing. I think comm score is where I realized that the impatience level from 8 seconds, the percentage about 2 years back used to wait 8 to 8, 10 seconds when the site didn't open. Now the impatience level has gone down to 4 seconds. So with the impatience level growing across the world, especially when you're booking your tourism products, people will find adoption of technology faster. Problem of payments, especially in this country, we have different sorts of payment source. A lot of people don't want to pay by their credit card, and this still serves as a deterrent. And hopefully, with the new reforms coming in, this should be taken tackled soon. Mindset, and this is my favorite. I speak to a lot of people around the world, most of the times, I tell clients, I tell people that I'm working with, colleagues, that sometimes we talk about these issues and these challenges on various forums, thinking that it's from an alien planet and there's a Mars out there and these people have these challenges and we have to sort of address them and comment on the same and then leave. My view of the same is that we are the decision makers. A lot of them are in this room, a lot of them are in different forums across across India, across the world. It's up to us to adopt technology. It's up to us to experiment with technology. Once we create that demand for technology, the integration will become seamless. So, almost coming to an end, saying that urging every community out there, it could be tourism, we are in the tourism vertical, so we're talking to the tourism community, that there should be a conscious decision to adopt and integrate. And that is when it will happen. Most of the things are not going to happen automatically. We have to make a conscious decision to make this happen. So let's make a conscious decision to make that happen in the tourism, Indian tourism space. And that's it. Thank you for your time.